Hey guys, what's going on? It's Jack here from Jacktastic PCs, and today we're going to be upgrading our Windows Server 2012 PC to Windows Server 2012 R2. So before we begin, we have to open up PowerShell and enter a few commands. Alright, so to open PowerShell, we just hit this little button right here. And what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to navigate to the drive where we have our installation media for Windows Server 2012 R2. Since this is a domain controller, we have to update a few pieces of software. So just put in D, colon, and now it's changing it to the D drive. Now we're going to put CD, support, and then you can just hit up on that command again, delete support, put in ADPREP. Now we can go ahead, delete the CD part, ADPREP.EXE, and then we're going to do forest prep. And now we hit C, and OK. And now it's going to go ahead and update this. And then once this is done, we're going to go ahead and run this command again. But this time it's going to be domain prep. And there we go. Super easy. Now all we have to do is go ahead and run the installation. So the reason I didn't just go ahead and install Server 2012 R2 off the back at the beginning of the series was because some of you guys might buy servers that already have Server 2012 installed on them, and you're going to need to know how to upgrade them to 2012 R2, and that's the purpose of this video. So now we can just hit no thanks for right now, speed up the process a little bit more, make sure to select the same version you selected before. You can go ahead and select core if you want. I'd recommend going with the GUI. It'll just be easier to learn. I will be going over server core in the future and how to switch back and forth between them. So just hit next. I accept the license terms, next again, and upgrade. Now this is going to take a second. It's going to check compatibility, and then we should be all set. So it says everything's all good. We can just hit next, and now it's going to go ahead and upgrade our virtual machine to Windows Server 2012 R2. So when that's all done, I'll be back to help make sure everything's going all right. And so while the installation's still going, I'm going to take a second to talk to you guys about fault tolerance and why it's important to have more than one server doing certain tasks in a environment where not having access to files or certain features on the network is a big no-no. So fault tolerance is having more than one server, power supply, so on and so forth, which means that something can fail and you'll still be able to work with it and fix it while something else takes over. So in the example of a domain controller, most small businesses and stuff will often only have one domain controller, if any, and so that means if anything happens to that, they're kind of shit out of luck. Bigger businesses, they often have multiple domain controllers with fault tolerance enabled. So let's say one server goes down for any number of reasons, or it needs to be upgraded or updated. All they have to do is power that machine off, and the network will automatically reroute all the traffic to the other domain controller. So it's just a seamless integration of features that allows them to continue working even when something's gone wrong or when something needs to be fixed. And so we'll be configuring fault tolerance with NICs and other things in the future. Alrighty guys, that took freaking forever, but it's all set. The installation is all done. So I'm just gonna go ahead, bring up the on-screen keyboard here. Control Alt Delete. And now we can go ahead and sign in. And bam, we're in. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. And just like that, we are running Windows Server 2012 R2. Just like that, that's all it took. And as you can see, one of the best features, it's not the regular start button, but at least they add it so you don't have to come all the way down here for that. And then, yeah. So everything, they also lowered this, so you don't have to go all the way up there for it. And as you guys can see, everything's working perfectly. We're still connected to the Jacktastic network. If you guys enjoyed this video, drop a like down below. If you didn't like it, drop a dislike. And if you really did, tell me why in a comment. Tell me what you'd like to see in a future video. And until next time, peace out.